Now we will see the structure of nephron. We will learn it over two videos. In this video we will see renal corpuscle and in next one renal tubule. You already know that this is renal parenchyma, the main functional area of kidney. Now let me show you some nephrons here. They are the functional units of the kidney. Each kidney has about 1 million nephrons. They are organized like this. Now let's focus on its structure. It is made up of two components. Glomerulus, which is a tuft of capillaries. And renal tubule, which is an epithelial structure. Functionally, it can be divided into two parts. Renal corpuscle or Malpighian corpuscle, where glomerular filtration takes place. And renal tubule, where tubular processing takes place. In this video, we will focus on renal corpuscle. There are two types of nephrons based on the location of renal corpuscle. Nephron with its corpuscle lying in outer cortex is called cortical or superficial nephron. 70 to 80% of total nephrons are cortical nephrons. Nephron with its corpuscle located close to the medulla is called juxtamedullary nephron. 20 to 30% of nephrons are of this type. Structure of both the types is essentially same, the only difference being the length of renal tubule. Now let's see the structure of renal corpuscle. It has three components: mesangial cells, glomerulus, and Bowman's capsule. Their arrangement can be easily understood if you know how the corpuscle forms during embryonic life. So let's go through it quickly. This is developing blood vessel, and this is the blind end of developing tubule. The corpuscle is formed by invagination of the tubule by developing vessel. The vessel grows into glomerulus. Mesangial cells grow among the glomerular capillaries, and the blind end of tubule becomes Bowman's capsule. As the blood flows through the glomerulus, it is filtered by these structures which form the filtration barrier. It includes capillary wall and visceral layer of Bowman's capsule. This is a simplified model. In reality, glomerulus is a capillary network. So if you see a cut section of real glomerulus, you will see something like this. But the fundamental arrangement is same, with mesangial cells in the center, surrounded by capillaries, which in turn is surrounded by Bowman's capsule. Now let's see each component one by one. First, the mesangial cells. They can be divided into two groups: intraglomerular mesangial cells, lying within the glomerulus, and extraglomerular mesangial cells, which lie outside the glomerulus. Intraglomerular mesangial cells provide structural support to the glomerulus. They are contractile. By contraction and relaxation, they can alter total surface area available for glomerular filtration and thereby can regulate the rate of glomerular filtration. They also have phagocytic activity. They secrete prostaglandins and also secrete extracellular matrix. Extraglomerular mesangial cells are part of juxtaglomerular apparatus. Next is the glomerulus. It is a network of branching and anastomosing capillaries. Blood comes in it via efferent arteriole, then it is filtered here. The filtrate then enters into the Bowman's capsule and moves ahead in tubule for further processing. Remaining blood leaves the glomerulus via efferent arteriole. Now let's have a closer look at the capillary wall. It consists of a single layer of endothelial cells and basement membrane. Endothelial cells have thousands of small pores called fenestra. The size of pore is about 60 to 80 nanometers. They provide free passage to plasma but restrict the blood cells. The basement membrane is made up of three layers: an inner thin layer called lamina rara interna, a thick layer called lamina densa, and an outer thin layer called lamina rara externa. It is composed mainly of collagen type 4 fibers and glycoproteins like heparan sulfate. Glycoproteins have negative charge on them. Basement membrane is also porous, The size of pore is about 8 nanometers. It allows free passage of water and small molecules, but it prevents filtration of plasma proteins. Negative charge on glycoproteins of basement membrane limits the filtration of negatively charged molecules. Finally, we have Bowman's capsule. As you can see, it is the blind end of renal tubule and it encases the glomerulus. It has two layers. The outer layer is called parietal epithelial layer, and the inner layer that covers the basement membrane is called visceral epithelial layer. The space in between two is called Bowman's space. The outer parietal layer is a simple squamous epithelium. The inner visceral epithelial layer is a part of filtration barrier. It is made up of cells called podocytes. They are named podocytes because they have food processes extending from cell bodies. Food processes of adjacent podocytes interdigitate with each other and form the filtration barrier. The gap between two food processes is called filtration slit. This slit is approximately 25 nanometers wide. It has membrane-bound proteins like nephrine and podocine. They make a thin membrane called slit diaphragm. Pores in this slit diaphragm range from 4 to 14 nanometers. Podocytes also have negative charge on their surface. They provide additional restriction to the filtration of negatively charged molecules. Remember, these endothelial cells, the basement membrane, and podocyte layer form the filtration barrier through which the blood is filtered. This completes the renal corpuscle. In next video, we will see renal tubule. Thank you.